believe it's past four, so we're gonna go ahead and start. Anybody else got them passport gun? I will too. They pull down another chair, and join us. And you all should feel free, because I'm gonna be referring to a mock-up up here. Feel free to come up, and if you want to, you can pull your chair closer. It's not like we have 100 people here, so.
Have you copied some?
I don't with me.
Well, with.
Don't.
I just, fine.
If anybody wants one, just leave it.
I didn't think we could reduce that down again, just where it would be. Not a whole lot you could, ability to get any kind of detail if we did that, but, I can get you a copy of a large one that you can get from me, next week, if you wanna do that.
Yeah.
I'll make the point to do it. I don't know, are you planning on going to their Tuesday meeting on agenda review or not?
Probably not.
Okay, well, I'll get it to you.
Okay.
But seriously, you should feel free, because it's not gonna be easy to describe some of these things about you all. Looking at it, on this map that's up here. I think pretty much all of you know each other. I didn't meet one gentleman, but I will before he gets out of here today. But again, I'm John King. I'm sort of the moderator, I guess, for today. And we have Mike Rousseau's a consultant with us on this project now. Randy Gennard is the developer. And Mr. Fulton here is the engineering firm that's working on this with us. And I will be representing the developer at the upcoming meetings. I wanted to cover this a little bit, and I'll leave it here when we get to the end and let you all look at it, but I needed to explain a few things about it. If you look at it like this, here's Beverly. Here's Mr. McMillan's property. And
McMillan's more than one.
Well, the
McMillan. The only ones you hear about.
That's right. The McMillan.
I'm aggravating more long time.
I love them.
I've made him a bunch of money in the past.
One of the things to know about it is the white that is on here does not equate, doesn't mean that's all covered or all building. That's the separate zero lot line unit. And there's the dwelling structure itself has front and rear setbacks, which will be as to each one of those units, which would have the effect of increasing, if you will, the green areas on here. We got a green where obviously the development is not.
Essentially, the white is just the areas that would be the lots that would be private.
That'd be a way to think about it. It'd be like a lot. Setback on the front and back, setback in front is 20 feet, and the rear is 15. So you would increase and show more green if you put it on here that way. What we did is concentrated the development in the areas that are suitable for building as opposed to getting into the hillside and the ridge top. The development proposal before, a year ago, more than a year ago, year and a half at least now, involved some of those slopes with higher degrees of slope, shall we say, and we've avoided that in this particular proposed development. Legacy parks expressed interest in this park that's in the floodway, and also wanted to have an easement here for a walking trail that comes out at either end and ultimately would tie to further development of that walking area on both ends, but that's not currently there. We're in agreement with them. We have no problem in doing that, so they have that easement, and it will be for public use as well. We do have some added features of clubhouse and pool area for some amenities. We have submitted our request to MPC seeking to have this property in total rezoned to DR, planned residential, at 3.5 units to the acre. As all you know, I think probably most of you, at least that I know, are very familiar with the process. What happens is, once it's rezoned, this is for information purposes. The actual concept plan and the use on review process will follow the rezoning, and at that time is when this becomes even more relevant. But we're saying, telling you now that it is, in essence, going to look like this. We asked for 3.5 units to the acre. We haven't surveyed this whole property. The lines which lines is it that they shot?
The line that adjacent to your to McMillan property has been shot, so we know that's correct.
And was it,
it's just up along the ridge.
There was one other line shot, and we got a good one.
And the railway, all the railroad right away. That was it.
Yeah. So that we've got a pretty good estimate as to the number of acres, but there seems to be some discussion about exactly how many acres are involved. Taking the lowest possible number of acres that might wind up being involved at 61 acres, 3.5 units to the acre amounts to 213 points units.
One point of clarification on that is the floodway area is part of the property, but that is not included in the estimate because that can't be counted toward density anyway. So essentially, we're just using the area outside of the floodway to determine.
Would you give a definition of the word floodway is a particular meaning?
Well, as designated by the FEMA map, and that's what MPC uses, that no development allowed.
In talking with MPC staff, they've indicated that the number they're using as a base to start with is 88 acres. I think to get to the 61 number I was talking about, you be using a 78 acre number to begin with, then take out the
What I was getting at is definition of floodway and floodplains are totally two different things.
That's floodplain, excuse me.
The floodway is actually half what they FEMA deems the floodplain. If this is the 100 year floodplain right here, we have half this distance is the floodplain.
All I know is there is a delineation on the maps. There's a designation on the maps, and that's what they're using as what amounts to the flood plain.
Yes.
And that's what they're using.
100 or 500.
The floodway, and you're correct.
If we're being really specific, it's not halfway. The floodway and the floodplain don't really have that much to deal with each other. So it is not halfway. If it was halfway, ever anywhere in the world, it's a coincidence.
It's
the rule that the county uses, and that's my understanding, is that no fill is allowed, and this may be what you're referring to.
They go halfway and we're not touching the
floodway. Participate in the flood insurance program.
No fill. Halfway between
That's also the city. Mm-hmm. The city adopted it 5 or 10 years.
Yeah. And that's not a FEMA requirement, that's just a local city.
Yeah, that's a local one. But we're not proposing to do anything for that.
The city and Knoxville to participate in the flood insurance program.
We're not going to have anybody, none of this is within.
We'll get into that later.
And that's the reason for a possible difference as to the number of acres. But in any event, what we'll be asking for is a sufficient number of units to the acre to equal a minimum of 210 units. That's what, again, this plan shows, 210 units. I have said if there's a discrepancy or some discussion about exactly how many acres there are to determine that density, we're willing to say that we want 3.5 units to the acre, but no more than 210 units. And that takes care of the problem, any possible problem about how many units you're talking about as far as this development is concerned. Now, we have had a lot of conversation with staff at MPC. We've been on site with a number of people, including the representatives from Legacy, Knox County Transportation, I believe, had a representative go out there to confirm our site distance, things like that. But we have sufficient site distance. We're hopeful, based on the things we've done to massage what was before Planning Commission, before it was withdrawn. We've made changes in where we're putting these units. Other significant changes are we're going to have permeable pavers for the roads and for the drives into the individual driveways into the individual units.
We want to do that. It's subject to Knox County. Okay.
Well, you know, we got other things subject to that. that's where we're headed. Chris Grosshue was a visitor at the site with a group of people, including me. This whole idea was discussed with him at that time. I don't know whether he's going to be there Thursday or not, but we've asked him if he can to be there.
Is that the reason they're showing no ponds anywhere on this property except the there with the road?
Yes, sir. If you look at it, calculate into the additional green and on those setbacks as to each unit. Put those in, and then if you get water coming off the ridge, it's going to be, shall we say, meandering more than sheet flow because of the structures that are going to be there, the roads that are going to be there, etc. So we don't have any on there, and I'd yield to Billy to talk about that. Might as well talk about it now. Just go ahead.
Well, so for now, we're looking at the rezoning. We kind of showed a little area here for some detention. Once we get into the detailed design of it, basically you would lose units to put ponds in if you needed more ponds, more storage.
Well, I mean, not mean to interrupt.
Well, we're going to ask this. We were going to let questions come at the end, but you go ahead. The crowd's not that big.
Yeah. Well, still, you've got 100 or 70 or 80 homes right there that's drained straight off. And unless it's impervious or you've got something back there, I know this is more in the detailed concept phase and the engineering. You're catching a little bit here and doing something, but over here you're doing nothing. And right now, about to be
over. You say over here you're doing nothing, where do you point to?
The lower end. Right along the creek, you're going to have acres of impervious surface right there that's straight runoff, no detention, no nothing, that will dramatically alter the flow of White Street.
Well, all I can say is when we get to the further engineering
stage. I think what you're saying is if we were to design it where it would run right into the creek, we would further impact White Street.
Well, you have nothing to slow. If your impervious surface is just going to be your roads, which is the orange, and the
that's not going to be impervious.
Pervious. I'm sorry, you're right. Yes, that helps a lot. But still, past that, on the downhill slope, you've got the whole first row of houses right there. You know, that nothing will be caught. And that would dramatically increase the flow.
You're saying if it were not caulked, it would dramatically increase.
Well, if it
I don't see any design here, so you're telling me that the design does not catch it, but I'm not seeing any design. So if you were to say if the design were not to catch it, then you're correct.
And
I don't want you to label the design that we haven't designed.
Well, this starts in the planning phase. Maybe my question is to you, all of this stuff, planning is a big thing, but this impacts people, thousands of homes and everything downstream. But still, whether you have stormwater ponds or whatever in here, if you put pump, say for instance right now, say, okay, we'll just put a pond in here, then you're getting down flood away. You're putting obstructions there to catch and hold water that's coming down. That will be an obstruction for the water coming down here plus the water coming in.
Well, we've had discussions about this. Obviously, we know that the runoff coming down off the mountain in its natural state now, or off the ridge, I should say, is unobstructed. And
mountain.
It's unobstructed and flows right into the creek. It's my opinion and Billy's. Correct me if I say something wrong here, but the county requires that once pre and post development there will be no additional runoff and whatever retention is required to do that.
You forgot flow.
ends up being that there's less runoff after the development, because a lot of it is caught and retained or detained, whichever the case may be, and I'm not sure, I'm not an engineer, but.
Retained means it stays there, detained is it slows.
Right. Is that generally correct?
Yeah, that is correct.
Okay, I mean, that's been, you know.
What's Mr. Rappin?
We'll talk about this anytime, I'm sorry.
That's okay. What's gonna happen is, the calculations have been made, that, okay, this is what's gonna be done. This is the units gonna be there. We're gonna calculate what the pervious surfaces that are being added and so forth, what all that does, and the objects of all of that is to determine whether or not, after this development is done, does it end up putting more water into the creek than is currently being put into the creek off of this property.
I'm sorry, I got the cart in front of the board.
It's all right. If it's doing that, then we have to design features to correct that. And the idea is that, once again, that post-completion, you're not putting any more water into the creek than is going into it right now. And in fact.
Flow rate.
Well, the flow rate.
Peak flow rate.
Well, that will be part of those calculations, I believe. And all I can say to you is, looking at it like I'm looking at it now, I think you look at it maybe differently, I don't know. But the water that you're concerned about, it's got a different velocity when it's coming off the ridge. It gets to here, and the design of the development itself starts dispersing water in different ways rather than just a sheet flow. And again, all that's gonna be a matter of hydrological evaluation. What's a science, you know? You have to have some assumptions, I guess.
Well, you know, I got your number in my phone. I'm about to call you and tell you to leave my lawyer alone.
No, I'm sorry. I know this is concept, this is an idea, and this is the
it's
first.
It's not even a concept.
So let's get it.
Yeah, I mean, that'll come all come about. And that's been all.
I apologize to all, the, you know.
Okay. Apologies accepted.
Okay.
This time.
I have a chewer,
this time.
Hey, it wouldn't be as much fun if you weren't digging.
The development is proposed has really probably the least amount of disturbance out there for the development as one could expect or one could have. It's if you look at the map as far as the slope and all is concerned, this development avoids them all. You don't have, it's not like we got to move a whole lot of dirt around. It's basically what I'm saying to do this. As I said, Legacy Park has expressed interest. We have a letter from them acknowledging that they've been there and that they are interested in and ultimately taking over this down here. I talked about the site distance. We've talked about the water issue. It goes without saying that, and I'm going to say it, even though it goes without saying it, if there's flooding, out there now, water problems now, this project is not going to cure those problems or those issues, but our function and our job is to see to it that we don't make it That's what the county requires. That's what we'll be, it's not some necessarily noble thing on our part. It's naturally our interest, and that's what we want to do. But that's also what the county is requiring.
What about digging on top of the ridge to make a walking trail?
Pardon?
Y'all going to dig on top of the ridge to make a walking trail? You said something about a walking trail on top of the ridge.
Yes, sir. That's going to be cooperation between us and Legacy. And
because I live on the other side, and I can tell you how the water runs off that ridge.
Well, I can,
it flows.
I can tell you that we're not interested, and we won't be getting into any development of their walking trail. We get outlines for it, where it is on the ground, and they're going to be the ones that take care of it, maintain it, etc. I don't know. I've been in the past. I don't know of any instance where they've done much, shall we say, really development work on those easements. They sort of lay it out, and they might go in there and cut down brush and everything to make a clearing. But I don't think they do much else other than that. Have you had any experience with them?
That's on this side is going to be a problem. You start, whoever it is, you or whoever, starts digging on that ridge. Because that ridge is like that on his side. On the other side, it's not as bad. And it flows off that. Because where our house sits, the natural flow flows away from our house. Because of the way the ridge is. And they start digging, making a trail or something, and they throw it off the natural. It'll flood me out in a hurry. It comes off that ridge big time. I've lived out there for a long time.
I guess we'll get you out there too when they come along and we start to see where their trail ought to go. But, it's not like we're going to go up there with a couple of pieces of heavy equipment.
Your property. Well, no, they on the other side.
See, I know exactly where my property is.
And at this point, 100
years ago, there was a barbed wire fence put up by the property line. Fence is still there. And on the other side, his side, it's like that, because when I was a kid, we used to go on that ridge and slide down through our windstone.
Well, I think it's important to note that at this point, we certainly are proposing not to develop in that whole area that's green. There have been some initial talks with Legacy Parks, and they're interested in trying to connect the greenway system. New Harvest.
New Harvest.
And then on up somewhere up off of Tazewell. This is one leg of it. Obviously, if that is done, it would have to be transferred to the public, and then they're, I'm not sure what exactly their processes are, but I know Legacy.
I heard it heard again. There's going to be a walking trail on top of that ridge. And if they do that, they're going to be somebody digging to put the trail up.
Sure.
Out.
No, I know generally they follow.
Let me cover that. That's a good point. That walking trail shows us a nice straight line, following a nice straight line on this document. In actuality, what it'll be when we get on the ground is it'll meander because there'll be natural features that they're going to have to avoid. And we're going to have to get around one way or the other and that sort of thing. I don't like that, and we're not going to be getting over on anybody else's boundary, over the boundary to do it. And when they hit areas have a natural feature that's a problem, this is going to be answered. It's going to go a different direction for a while and then pick back up. It will stay as close to that boundary line as possible.
The only flat part of that part where I live in is on my side of the property. Now, we started to build our house all the way to the top 47 years ago. But we changed our mind and build it down. When you get up on top, my property's like this, the other side's like that. But I don't know about all the way up toward New Beverly Baptist Church, and as you go down toward Beverly Road, there ain't much distance between where I live and where the mountain goes.
When we get through here, I want you to come show me on this, and you can't do it on this. Well, I got some more here where your property is in relation to this. And let me
they meander off the property. They did that to us, and we had to call the tail and say, and they moved it over.
We'll just have to make sure that it stays within our boundary.
Well, and if they do that, obviously that's beyond our control, but the only land that at least they would have control of is this, unless somebody else gets it named as well, so they would have to stay on there. And I was leading into before King John sort of said it, but generally the greenways, if you look at them, they follow the, they follow the path of least resistance to contour. A lot of it's because there's just not a lot, there's a minimal amount of money to do that, and so they try to, do it as well, without minimizing the cost of it, and having to move a lot of dirt around, all that certainly increases the cost. So, I agree with John that we don't know, but ultimately it's going to be meandering. It's certainly not going to follow a straight line. You look at most, it'll be like any other trail that goes up a slope, it'll wind back and forth and follow the path of least resistance.
I'll do pieces of property. Brought this over here, it's got a line, but I don't know I drew a circle all the way around it.
Okay.
And I'm going to draw one in the center where it's
sweeping. Okay.
And it looks like it's a very small line, and I own that fire.
Well,
at that ridge.
Show me what.
The Marcus Lane, it ends somewhere right in here, and then we built a drive. That's a driveway. That's not a county road. County road ends there. We built the driveway coming through here. Our house sits on this piece of property, and that's property about here.
Where's the cell tower at? It's right there close.
Okay.
Right there.
Okay.
All right.
That's
good.
On my property.
We just want to make sure we know.
Nice to meet you, neighbor. I live on the other side here.
But that's flat where I live.
Okay.
Cool. And on the other side, on top, it's like this. It's almost straight up and down on the back side of that.
Which is
because we started to build our house up there on that hill 40 something years ago.
Okay.
We did.
Well,
to get up there, it would cost a lot more money to build the road to the top of the hill. But it was kind of flat enough to build a house up there. But you wouldn't have a big, very big yard.
So the road just goes, the road going up there is goes
yeah.
up.
There's also a map up here that shows the slope area and we're staying out of the issues with bridges. Anybody needs to
I'll pass this around. This was the slope map that last time when NPC reviewed it, they produced, and we had specific instructions when we went back to meet with staff. Their recommendations were no matter what you're going to do, units and whatever, you need to stay more out of the slope, because initial plans actually had another road. These roads were closer together, but there was a third road that came up here and got into that slope. There was a couple of little cul-de-sacs that at one time were proposed. And keep in mind, the previous proposal at that time, it was detached units, which require larger lots. So, there was less lots, but it required more land to do it. And, Gerald even specifically said, consider attached for part or all of it. And when we talked with Randy about that, we thought that it would make a viable plan to keep us out of the slope. So we've really, everything the staff has suggested between that time and now, we've really done our best to accommodate that.
Now, the further back you get there are a lot of room. Mm-hmm. But when you come in off the one way in and one way out, there's not much room there. But you like this right here, and then you got in White Creek. Mm-hmm. It's not much, and I know she got houses. Look like it's going all the way out to the road there, Beverly Road.
There's it's like a boulevard entrance there, and if you looked at what's there now, that gravel area off of Beverly Road right there, and where the gate and all is, if you look at that, imagine that the actual entrance for this is going to be to the south of where that.
Then you're getting up on that ridge a little bit.
Yes, sir.
Because they've cut down some trees just
one, right. One place, one, the one area where we'll have to do some work like that is right there.
Yeah, the most grading will be required right near the entrance.
And I
sewer line that runs all the way up through there. Y'all got that marked on? There's a sewer line that runs all the way up there.
He's familiar with that.
Okay, you beat it in there several years ago.
There's two sewer lines.
I know of one, because I...
Well, there's one abandoned that collapsed.
We're aware of that. As a matter of fact, that's...
It's out of the flood.
That's, what we're going to be using for this development.
But what I was going to point out is that, you know, where the red is on these slope maps, that's the steepest parts. And, you know, obviously, the back bar, we know it's steep, but all of our development, the only part that's not green, essentially, that we would need to mess with is just a little bit right here. The rest of this, all that development you see, it matches up with the plan. It'd be in this green area, so you're welcome to look at that if you'd like.
How far through there does the land go? Does it go all the way up as far as the New Beverly Baptist Church area is? You know what I'm talking about? The New Beverly Church Road?
That New Beverly Church Road, that's over there, off of...
It's off Greenwood. New Beverly Church Road is off of Greenwood.
We get to a point about equal with or across. We have a target price market in the range of $225 to $275, in that range. You could say it'd be an average of $250,000.
Mr. King, but is this your idea of, I mean, we weren't told we were going to be filmed at a meeting. I don't like this at all. I really don't.
Michelle Carringer told me about the meeting at the Sunshine meeting that I attended, and I believe this meeting was advertised in the paper as a public meeting.
It was advertised. And I am, Mr. King, was this your idea to have it filmed while we're here?
I'm a blogger. I showed up on my own because Michelle told me about the meeting on Tuesday.
I don't have a problem with it being filmed.
So I know you don't, but we do. I don't like it.
Well, if you got something you want to say directed to this or some question you want to ask.
No, I just don't think it's right.
If you have a question or something you want clarified, wait till the end when I say, you know, it's open now for questions and all. You tell me, I'll tell you to turn it off.
No,
and you
can ask your
questions. Okay?
That's not the problem. We were told there was a meeting. We didn't know this was going to happen. I don't like it.
Just know that we did invite it to public meeting. Anybody can come.
I've got another meeting.
Okay. Square footage?
Oh, yeah. 1,700 to 2,200, thereabouts. There'll be a couple different options for people to choose as far as square footage.
And they all connect.
Not all. I mean, there's combinations of three. And you see when the blocks, they're anywhere from two to four.
Twos, threes,
and fours. Mostly fours.
So are they going to be built straight up and the garages underneath?
We'll have some units with garages underneath, probably in the area down closer to the entrance. Otherwise, they have where the garages on the others are in the front of
322.
Because that area along the front, like when if you came in off of Beverly on the right side, that's where the slope is closest to our development. So we're taking advantage of that slope. Taking advantage of the slope to go ahead, you know, that allows you to do a, basically the garage would come in at the level. Park and then go upstairs, and then there'd be a back door that would go out. You know, basically, you know, here's the slope, the garage, you go in here, the house would be sort of built into the slope a bit. And because of that, the houses will actually serve as, you know, retaining it. We don't expect there to be any retaining walls, with the exception of that area where the structures themselves would serve that purpose.
So it's not being built for, like, not in James's age enough. It's for young people, because they can't, that's the main thing, that's the one thing we need.
They can't vote.
Younger people, because my age enough does not want a garage and walk upstairs.
Only 20 units will have that, only 24 units or something, the rest of us is all one level.
And like I said, the reason for that was to stay as much out of the slope as possible, but, and, but it gives you the opportunity to do that for the people that do prefer to have.
I think we counted them as possible, and it was 21 or 2 or so that we're talking about, that were garage down, so to speak. The rest of it, all on the level. You get your choice, but whether you want that or not. I think that that pretty well covers all the points I knew of that you all are interested in, except for the traffic. And there will be a traffic count that is going to be calculated, and it will require this project, when proposed at the concept level, will require a traffic study, and we'll have to do whatever they say in order to.
7:30 in the morning, 3:30 to 6 o'clock at night. Bumper to bumper through that a lot of times. I live there. I know the traffic. 7 o'clock to 8:30 in the morning, it's almost impossible to be turned.
They'll have a traffic study done. It will have a peak number of traveling units, peak number per hour, by the hour. So they'll have information as to how many vehicles are during the peak hour in the morning, peak hour in the afternoon, et cetera.
This traffic camp is on here?
Yeah.
We've been right outside this land.
Yeah, there's some traffic camp on this that you can look at as to what's there now. And you can look over here and see where your property is and look in here.
Well, my property's all around.
It's on here, if that's where we got it. That's where they did. This is a
not one just like
this is a county traffic camp. And it's just
the reason there are not more people here is people didn't know about it. They met 4 o'clock in the afternoon. So that's why you don't see it.
We gotta get it when we can get it. We tried one or two places and we were having trouble finding something available. And also trying to get it in before the meeting next week.
Yeah, I know. I mean, but that's why it's not full, because there was, you know, unless people take the paper, there was no way of picking up.
The only reason I knew, I got a postcard in the mail from the city county building. I don't have a paper anymore because it's $500 a year, it ain't worth $50 a year.
They reduce the size and increase the cost.
That's right.
I'll tell you,